Javon and Kato here with Live It Up. It's a beautiful night in Brooklyn, New York, US of A. Guess where we are headed? We are headed to one of the hottest nightclubs in Brooklyn, Milk River, for the 6th annual iTAC fundraiser spearheaded by Susan Samuel, educator, entrepreneur. I can't wait to meet her. I know you can't. There are going to be government officials, celebrities. Stick around.
So many people here that have blossomed because this energy started from the grassroots when I first met Susan, the executive director, as a child, and I mentored her into adulthood, and she became an entrepreneur because at one time I was an entrepreneur, so I did sow good seeds that helped her develop in terms of her education, in terms of her being an entrepreneur, and that's why we're here today, so many people, because what you do is if you keep passing the love on, then you will get nothing but grow, because love is the message.
Well, I got an award because when Susan Samuel started the organization years ago, we met, and she was very persistent. She wanted me to know that she had this great organization that would be very helpful to the community. And after a few phone calls back and forth, I finally decided to do a story on it, and that kind of introduced the organization to New York City. And it, as she said, it opened up a lot of doors for her. I was just trying to tell a good story, and it turned out that it worked out very well for her.
There you go. As the kids say, you turned it up for Susan. You turned it up. I like that. And you said she was very persistent. Yeah. She left several phone calls, several messages. Yeah. And so that tells you out there, persistence, it does work. It works. And thank you for just creating. You're taking ideas and creating a great story and presenting it to New York for us. We really appreciate that.
Thank you. It was great to do that. You know, that's what we do at New York One. We try to highlight community people, what they're doing, you know, highlight the people who are really going above and beyond. And Susan's just one of those people. So, you know, we got lucky running into each other. And sometimes they say, you know, luck is opportunity, meaning for timing or preparedness. But she was very prepared, and she was very persistent, and it just goes to show just a little bit of persistence, you know, can go a long way. I mean, the organization is a lot larger than when I first interviewed her, but, you know, it's just wonderful to see it grow.
It's easy for me to be on television. The papers write about me, everything I do, good and bad. But voice for the voiceless. Standing up for those that can't stand up for themselves. This is real to me. This is why I want to be here tonight. Never judge a book by its cover.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
You judge my book, you see a suit and a tie, but you know, and yes, you know, the money that comes along with it, that's television. But what you don't know, these are the heroes.
Amen.
That take care of our little ones. I was once one of those little ones in the care of people like this. What you don't know about my story is that my mother suffered from severe mental illness. My mother was a chronic paranoid schizophrenic. My father never signed my birth certificate. I don't have a father on paper. All I have are heroes like this. people like this. Now every child can get the books because the digital books bring down the cost, and they all and the tablet is a low cost tablet as well. And as you can see, it has our company logo on it, and it says concept by United Vision Marketing Firm, all rights reserved, 2013 USA, the pen K15 model, technology manufactured in China. And so I just really wanted to let them know that when they laughed at me and when they said that I couldn't do it, well, today is a victory for God's kingdom because we did it. God bless you.
Well, I got involved with iTAC about a couple of years ago, and I sponsored a summer camp for the kids that one year, and it turned out pretty good. They were actually doing business plans and marketing plans at 8 and 9 years old, so it was amazing. And so I got involved with that in terms of helping the kids learn about entrepreneurship and marketing, and so been helping Miss Samuel ever since with it.
And you guys look like you have a good partnership going. I really like the energy. She also mentioned that Forbes listed you as one of the future billionaires. I know you don't really like to talk a lot about it, but I hear the Rolls Royce coming. So can we talk about it?
Well, yes. I actually I did a thing where I put financial literacy in hip hop, and we released it on Island Def Jam Digital Distribution, and for that. Vision, talking about how we have to actually develop the market and teach our youth about investments and financial literacy because the baby boomers were retiring. Forbes thought it was honorable enough to put me in their world's billionaires list. And we've actually been 2011 and 2012 a finalist in Forbes Search for America's Most Promising Company. So they've really given me a lot of credibility with their name. Yes, the PET is short for Pearson Education Tablet. And it's a low-cost digital tablet that is very high quality, but it's a low-cost tablet that would allow students to get digital downloaded books, bringing down the cost of education, making sure that we can have trees and we don't have to use all of the paper in the world for books. So it's something that we is our pet project, as we like to say. And we're targeting over 250 million students around the world that's out of education in terms of engagement and technology. Lil Wayne has an alter ego called Dr. Carter. Nobody knows, a lot of people don't know this, but Lil Wayne went to college and he almost graduated with an MBA. So we want him to do a Dr. Carter album and release it first on the PET, talking about how he's an educated businessman.
I love that idea. I hope I'm there to see that happen.
I think it's gonna be a great album.
I'm here with Colette with Super Wings. Tell us a little about Super Wings and where it is located.
Super Wings is a Caribbean-inspired wing joint, and we are located at 1218 Union Street between Nostrand and Rogers Avenue. We've been there for the past 5 years, since 2009, and we have won the best wings in Brooklyn for the past 5 years.
Go ahead on, girl. I'm from the South, so I know a little bit about chicken wings, and I read a little bit of your bio, and you said growing up you ate wings 2-3 times a day, right?
Yeah, I love wings.
I'm the same way with pizza, so
nice.
2-3 times a day, I'm with you. But I'm glad that you branched out with the wings, because you're right. Growing up, it was a hot wings, mild. Yeah. You never really had different flavors, maybe some lemon pepper.
Yeah.
But tell us about some of your Caribbean-style wings. What type of flavors are we talking about?
Well, I'm from Trinidad, if you can't tell from my accent, right? So I decided to span the Caribbean with wing flavors. So each of the wing flavors that we have at Super Wings is really fashioned after a different island.
Okay.
So we have the Bajan Mary Mango for Barbados. We have the Trini Tamarind for Trinidad. Jamaican, we have a Pineapple Jerk, which has won the National Buffalo Wing Festival. So we do every island. Right now we have 13 flavors, so we're still expanding.
Right.
But what we try to do is to embody the Caribbean through our flavors.
Like I say, you plant a good seed and it's bound to grow, and your dad did that, and you're here to see it out and plant some more.
Yes, we will. I've already told Susan that the Thomas White Foundation will be making a contribution of $1,000 to the organization, and hopefully we can be able to continue to support her in the years to come.
I am standing here with the lady of the evening, Miss Susan Samuel. Thank you so much for everything that you did tonight. It's a beautiful venue. It was great. You did so well putting this together. We really appreciate it. Tell us when you started the entire organization, It Takes a Community to Raise a Child.
They always said every great business starts without your own necessity and need. Let's say this started, how old is my oldest? He'll be 26 next week.
There you go.
So it started when he was 2 years old, and I wanted to go out. And now as if I was in school or working, my mother was not having it. So I said, please, we live in a city that doesn't sleep. Why should our child care sleep? I'm going to find me 25 with child care, and lo and behold, I could not find one. So that's when the seed was planted and Dream was born.
I mean, it's a beautiful seed. You're not the only one that needs that service. You had a few people come up and speak on behalf of your program, and it's just amazing because, like you said, single parents, they want to go out. Single parents, they want to go to school. They want to have extracurricular activities just like everyone else. So do you find yourself having other competition, being that you started the first?
First of all, no.
Okay, I like it. Hit me. Let me hear it.
It's no competition. I am sorry.
Did you hit at New York City?
No competition.
No competition.
It Takes a Community to Raise a Child. New York's only 24 hours, 7 days a week, including holiday childcare after school learning center. For the city that doesn't sleep, why should your child can sleep? There is no competition. I'm sorry.
I love it. You heard it from the horse's mouth right here. No competition. So what do you have planned next?
Well, actually, I was looking for our newly elected Brooklyn Borough President, Eric Adams, to come in, and Senator Kevin Park was actually one of the honorees, because I'm looking to open up a center-based program here in Brooklyn.
Okay.
So right now we're a group family facility, meaning that I started on the second floor of my home, and I could take care up to about 12 children at a time. And now I'm looking to do a center-based right in Howard Houses, which would be the first done in New York City history ever to have a 24-hour childcare in NYCHA. And I will be able to provide childcare to 55 children at a time and creating 50 jobs within the community. But it's not just a 24-hour childcare. We got our Dream Catches. Once again, it's about teaching children about financial literacy and entrepreneurship. So the ones from 5 to 7 are about money and banking. Children from 8 to 13 start their own company. So I teach them about marketing, business plan, and they actually, had, like I said, their own business. And now my new program, which I'm so excited about, is EduDiva. EduDiva for the educated woman with style and grace. Now, I'm so tired of people looking at me thinking, oh, are you a makeup artist? Are you a fashion consultant? Nobody think I'm educated. I have 4 degrees. I'm a former New York City assistant principal.
And tell us about your 4 degrees and where you got them from.
Okay, I have an associate's in liberal arts and science from Queensborough Community College, a bachelor's of psychology from York, a master's in special education from Queens College, and a postgraduate, which is above a master's under a doctorate in school administration supervision from Queens College as well.
Well, now we see why she needed some 24-hour care with her kids, because Miss Thang was doing it out there.
And then I'm also permanently certified to teach grades pre-K, kindergarten to grades 1 through 6. I'm permanently certified to teach special education, K through 12. I'm permanently certified as a school district administrator, which means I could be a superintendent or chair if I choose to. And I'm permanently certified as a school administrative supervisor, because I could be assistant principal or a principal.